Mr. Tarrou.
Okay, let's finish this video about properties of logarithms. We just did a bunch of examples about expanding logarithms, and we're going to do one more of that, and then a few examples of condensing logarithms. Again, using the properties, the three properties of logarithms we have right here. Okay, so let's start off with log base 4 of the square root of x times y squared over 17. Okay, you do not want to work with logarithms, or excuse me, you do not want to work with radicals. They're nice for final answers, and you're comfortable with them maybe at this point in mathematics, but once you get used to fractional exponents where it's power over root, those are much easier to deal with. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of just go against my advice I gave you in the last video. Normally when you're expanding logarithms, this is the last property that you want to deal with, the power property, where you move those exponents out front. But since this expression is enclosed with one entire large square root symbol, a radical, that means this entire fraction that we're trying to log or expand for the log of is engulfed in the square root symbol. So there's a grouping symbol, and all of this expression is going to, we're going to rewrite it as log base 4 of xy squared over 17 to the 1/2 power. That 1/2 power is representing the square root symbol that's over this fraction. When you have fractional exponents, the top number is the power. Now inside this, we've got exponents of 1 and exponents of 2, and then we have a constant which have degrees of 0, but the entire expression has a power of, or at least the entire fraction underneath the radical, has a power of 1. That's what this 1 is coming from. And the root is the bottom number, and this was the second root. So the square root of xy squared over 17 becomes xy squared over 17 to the 1/2 power. Now again, we are trying to expand the log of this fraction, which is completely engulfed by the power of 1/2. So we are going to have to deal with that power property first and move the 1/2 out front. So that's going to give us 1/2 log base 4 of xy squared over 17. And now we can start pulling apart or expand this fraction. And we're going to first, like in the last video, deal with the division sign first. So we're going to do 1/2 times log base 4 of xy squared minus, that's for the division symbol, log of 17. Now, why did I wrap this inside parentheses and put the 1/2 out front? Because it's 1/2 this entire expression, which right now is just one term. But as we expand it to more terms, that 1/2 is going to have to be distributed to all of those terms, so you do need these parentheses and the 1/2 out front. So when we're done, we can distribute that through the entire problem. Okay, I want to pull this multiplication apart, so I'm going to have two logarithms added together. Log 1/2 log base 4 of x plus, for the multiplication, log base 4 of y squared minus log base 4 of 17. Now we're going to do one last step, which we're going to pull this 2 up front and use that power property. Then we're going to distribute the 1/2 through, and we're going to be done. So we have 1/2 times log base 4 of x plus 2 log base 4 of y minus log base 4 of 17. And your last step will be to distribute that 1/2 and you'll be done. 1/2 log base 4 of x plus log base 4 of y minus 1/2 log base 4 of 17. Bam! Last expansion problem done. Let's start doing some condensing problems. Okay, So first, a condensing problem. First where we have two logs and we're trying to write it as one singular log. So natural log of x plus natural log of 5. Well, that's pretty straightforward. Have I written a natural log yet? Yes, I have. Okay, so natural log, in the last video anyway, natural log is log base e. So natural log of x plus natural log of 5, two logs, both have a leading coefficient of 1, both have the same base of e, so we're just going to put those together and write the natural log of x times 5, or that's kind of unusual, how about 5x? Okay, one step, bam, done. Moving on. Woo! Okay, wake myself up this morning. How about 1/3 log of x plus log of y? Okay, now these are not going to just be slapped together like the last one was because we have a leading coefficient that's not 1. If you look at our properties, it's 1 log base b of m plus 1 log base b of n. And same thing with the division rule. You have to have leading coefficients of 1. So unlike with expansion of logarithms, which normally you want to do your power property last, except for that last example I did where it was, you know, the whole thing was in square root. With compression or when you're condensing logarithmic functions, a lot of times you're going to do the power properties first because you need those leading coefficients again to be 1. So this is going to come up and we have log of x to the 1/3 plus log of y, two logs, leading coefficients of 1, so then we get log of x to the 1/3 times y, write it as a single log. Our condensing is done. If you would like to write that as a third root of x at this point, that would be okay, but that's perfect. No one would have a problem with a fractional exponent, since you've probably been learning those recently. Okay, moving on. Let's take a look at 5. Natural log of x plus 7 minus 7 times the natural log of x. Now this time it's subtraction and not addition. So we're not going to set up a multiplication. We're going to set up a quotient or division. But like the last problem, we have leading coefficients that are not 1, so those powers come up. And we get natural log of x plus 7 to the 5th power minus natural log of x to the 7th power. And now that we have like bases, now that we have leading coefficients of 1, we can go ahead and apply that subtraction or condense those two logarithms, and we will get natural log of x plus 7 to the 5th power divided by x to the 7th. Now remember, when you take a log of a number, natural log, log base 10, log base, who cares? You do get an exponent. So this is effectively like the log of something is going to give you an exponent. The log of something gives you an exponent. Remember, like log base 10 of 100 is 2, that's an exponent. 10 squared equals 100 if you want to undo the log. And when do you subtract exponents? You subtract exponents when you divide under a like base, and our like base for natural log is, again, e, which is 2.718. One more example. And I'm not sure how much room this example is going to take, so I'm going to go ahead and erase my properties here. And start off with 1/3 times the log base 2 of x plus log base 2 of y minus 2 times the log base 2 of x plus 1. Okay, well, with logarithms, you do want to kind of follow the order of operations, not kind of, you kind of always want to follow the order of operations. And when you have something inside a parentheses that you can clean up, you know, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, whatever comes first, left to right, and then addition and subtraction, you want to keep those rules in your head, just like they have been, hopefully, pretty much your whole life. So we're going to work inside this parentheses where we have two logs with the same base that we can put together first. So this is going to be 1/3. And the addition of logs is going to give us log base 2 of xy minus 2 log base 2 of x plus 1. Okay, well this is going to be a little bit shorter than I thought. Now we're going to take these two powers, or the two leading coefficients, and move those up. So we're going to have log base 2 of xy. Now how am I going to write the 1/3? Because it's the 1/3 of this entire log. So when I move the 1/3 up, it's going to be wrapped around what I'm logging. So not just on the x, not just on the y, but x, y in parentheses with the 1/3 power minus log base 2. This is also going to come up as a power. And we already have parentheses here, so that probably would not be a place where my students would make mistakes. X plus 1 squared. And now that we have just two logs, same base, leading coefficients of 1, we can put those together. And remember, we are subtracting two logs, which is effectively like subtracting exponents. You subtract exponents when you divide like bases. So this is going to be log base 2, that common base of the division I just mentioned, of, you can write x, y to the 1/3 power, or you can write the cube root of x, y, because remember power over roots, that's the third root, over x plus 1 squared, and bam, I'm done. Thank you for watching. Hope they're helping.
Have a good day.